Hey guys, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I hope you all are doing well. So stay safe in this times of corona and prevent from going out if it is not necessary for you. So let's begin with this video. Let me inform you that this PDF is downloadable and the link is in description below. So the first question that we have is that where is the Koppal toy cluster located? So guys, here the right answer is option A, Karnataka. The Koppal is a place located in the northern side of Karnataka. Okay, so this is India's largest, this is India's first and biggest toy cluster that has been established, and it is expected to start its operation from April this year. That is the entire news all about, because of which it is important from your exam point of view. But guys, if you were to understand this, the importance of this cluster in light of India's import dependence, then this cluster assumes altogether another level of significance. So this, if you know that 80% of India's toys are imported and China is having a huge share in India's imports, especially in the sector of toys. So in order to reduce India's dependence on China, particularly for toys, at the same time increasing the employment opportunities in the toys manufacturing sector, this toy cluster has been established, and this gives another level, another layer of significance to this toy cluster. So now let's move on to the details of this news. So as I told you that it is located in the northern region and it is expected to start its operation. What are the things that you need to know apart from this? First of all, this information that it is going to employ 5,000 people in the first phase, and overall the employment is 25,000 directly and approximately 2 lakh indirectly. These statements, guys, are additional informations that you need not to memorize. But yes, here is a minor point that you may ignore or that might escape your eye. That is, okay, give me a second. This Equus Infra is the company that was given the contract for establishing the infrastructure at the toy cluster. So all the three buildings have been established or developed by this Equus Infra company only. So do pay attention to this. Now the next question is, which state is running the student startup and innovation policy? So here the right answer is Gujarat. From the very name of this policy, it is evident that this is going to boost the startups created by the students, as well as it is going to boost the innovation. Innovation, that means it is also going to train the students how to register their intellectual property and how to create their intellectual property. So that's the overall premise of this policy. Now let's move on to the details of it. First of all, you need to know that this policy was launched at International Conference of Academic Institutions that was held at the Science City in Gujarat. Now, this conference was held as a precursor to the 10th Vibrant Gujarat Global Summit, which is scheduled for January 10 to 11. Okay. Now, this second edition is basically is basically a successor of the first version. Now, this first version was about to end on January 10, 2022, and it had a tenure of 5 years. So at the end of this first version, the second version has been launched for a tenure of 5 years till March 2027. Now, what is the state government planning to do under this policy? So this policy aims to establish an innovation and incubation center at every university, at each of the 90 odd universities in the state of Gujarat. Apart from this, it will scale up 1500 student startups and incubate 500 startups through the iHub initiative, which is the Gujarat government's startup incubator. Okay, now apart from this, Australia, Canada, Norway, UK and France, all of these countries joined the state government of Gujarat to organize the conference. Okay, so these are the partner countries. Moving ahead, which district launched the Nirbhaya Kadhi campaign to end child marriage? So here the right answer is option B, Ganjam. This is, guys, Odisha's first district to become चाइल्ड मैरिज फ्री डिस्ट्रिक्ट. डू रिमेंबर इट इज द फर्स्ट डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ द स्टेट ऑफ ओडिशा, नॉट एंटायर इंडिया. ओके, सो दिस डिस्ट्रिक्ट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन वॉज एबल टू अचीव दिस माइल स्टोन बिकॉज ऑफ दिस कैंपेन. सो वॉट इज दिस कैंपेन ऑल अबाउट, लेट्स डिस्कस दैट. So guys, in order to stop the child marriage, the Ganjam administration launched this Nirbhaya Kadi, which means fearless bird. Now under this campaign, many activities were undertaken by the administration of this district in order to stop the child marriage. For example, they used to monitor the absent girls from the schools. If any girl is absent from the school for more than 5 days, then they definitely took it seriously and counseled the girl to not drop out from the school, to continue her studies, as well as not engage in the child marriage. So awareness was created among the parents of the children. At the same time, counseling was given to the girl children. Also, rewards were announced for the people who will inform the administration of any child marriage taking place anywhere in the district. Okay, reward money was also increased from 5,000 to 50,000, almost 10 time increase. So this is how seriously the administration of Ganjam had taken the campaign. Okay, so that's all that you need to cover from the exam point of view about this Nirbhaya Kadi campaign. Moving ahead, how much is the present non-fossil fuel based installed energy capacity of India? So, as you all are aware that India's target is to reach 175 gigawatt of renewable energy by 2022. And we are in 2022. So, how much is the government of India able to achieve from the target that it had set for itself? So, in light of this entire scenario, this question is very, very important. So the right answer is 157.32 gigawatts, which is very near to the target of 175 gigawatt, and the government is full of confidence that we will definitely achieve this 175 gigawatt of installed power capacity from the non-renewable sources. Okay, so let's move into the details of the news. What is the entire news all about? So guys, according to the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, India has already achieved one of its nationally determined contributions that state that India will source 40% of its electricity from the non-renewable resources. Okay, so that is already achieved by India, and this NDC, that 40% of the electricity would be from non-renewable resources by the year 2030. So this was the target, but India has achieved it way ahead from the deadline. Okay, so it was achieved in November 2021 only, and precisely because of this, it is entirely in the news. That question was there. Okay, now Panchamrit of India announced that now the target will be 50% of the electricity generated in India would be from the non-renewable sources. Okay, India ranks fourth in terms of installed renewable energy capacity at present. Now what is the bifurcation of energy? Okay, how much do we extract from solar, from wind, small hydro, etc., etc., that we will discuss. But you need to know that this much is the present electricity generated from the non-fossil fuel based energy sources, which is 40.1% of the total electricity generated in India. That is 39.01 gigawatts. Okay, now if you want to bifurcate it, so solar gave 48.55 gigawatt, wind contributes 40.03 gigawatts, small hydropower projects contribute 4.83 gigawatt, biofuels 10.62, large hydropower projects give 46.51 gigawatts, and nuclear contributes 6.78 gigawatts of energy. Guys, can you tell me what is the target of India in terms of solar energy, wind energy, hydro energy by 2022? Okay, I already told you that 175 gigawatt is the target, but there is a bifurcation of each and every resource also. Okay, so I have asked you solar, wind and hydro, and if you know other resources as well, so do mention it in the comment section below. Moving ahead to the last question of today. So, which city will host the 5th edition of the Khelo India Youth Games 2022 to 2023? So, here the right answer is Bhopal. So, guys, this is the 5th edition. 4th edition of this this Khelo India Youth Games is expected to take place in Haryana at 5 cities. So, we will look at that also here. First of all, you need to know that Madhya Pradesh has announced that it will host this Khelo India Youth Game 2022 to 2023, which is going to be the 5th edition in the city of Bhopal. And for this only, the certain amount of funds have been allocated by the Madhya Pradesh cabinet to construct the stadium in Bhopal city for this Khelo India Youth Games only. Karnataka is going to host the 2nd edition of Khelo India University Games. This is basically the 2020 edition, which is now delayed, 2021 edition, okay. This is 2021 edition that has been delayed due to corona. Next is 2021 Khelo India Youth edition, that is Khelo India Youth Games, that is the 4th edition that was about to take place in 2021 but delayed, and now it will take place in February 2022. It will take place at 5 cities: Panchkula, Ambala, Chandigarh, Shahabad, Delhi. So do remember all these locations. Now guys, I hope that you are aware of the format of Khelo India Games. So it take place in 3 formats: Khelo India Youth Games, Khelo India University Games, Khelo India Winter Games. As you can see, the categories are divided on the basis of years, okay, of the age of the participants. So Youth Games are basically for the school children, that is under 17 years of students can participate. University Games are for the college level students, so under 25 can participate, and there is no age limit as of now under the Khelo India Winter Games. So 2021 venue of the Youth Games, that is the school games as you can say, is Panchkula, Haryana. Oh, the 2021 edition for the University Games is Karnataka, Bangalore, and the Winter Games is Gulmarg, Jammu and Kashmir. And in this games that were held in 2021 only, Jammu Kashmir had topped the medal tally with 11 gold medals, 8 silver medals and 5 bronze medals. Okay, so that is how the sports is taking shape in India. It's being promoted in India. So guys, this is all about the questions for today. Now it's time for the GK Factory section. So let's move into the section. Here, guys, we talked about the Khelo India Games. Why is the Khelo India Games important? Because the state of India, basically the state government, the Union Government of India, aims to promote sports at the very grassroots level. But why is the government so hell-bent on improving sports? We had Fit India campaign, Fit India run also. So why? Firstly, the very first motive behind this is to promote sports for a healthy lifestyle. But the second very important purpose is to make the people Olympic ready, make the sports persons Olympic ready. That's why the Khelo India Youth Games are so promoted. Okay, otherwise why do you think that we are the population of approximately 140 billion people at present? Okay, so why aren't we able to get so many Olympic gold medals like USA, China, Russia, etc.? So many countries are there who get so many gold medals, who get so many silver medals, and overall medals are also, the number of overall medals are also high. What are the reasons that India is not able to get the gold medals? Only 2 individual gold medals have been won by Indians. First is by Abhinav Bindra and second is by Neeraj Chopra, and that too after a very long gap. Okay, so why is it so? We will come to know the reasons, we will explore the reasons by the time we go through the entire GK section for today. But first of all, I want to inform you about certain facts regarding Olympics that are really very interesting. So first fact is that it was started in Athens, 1896, Greece. So guys, this is the location of Athens. I hope that it is visible. Even if it is not visible, you will get the PDF so you can see it from there. So this, guys, location is very important because the Olympic flame Olympic flame, I hope that you are all aware that there is an Olympic flame that is lit before the beginning of the ceremony and it is extinguished at the end. So this Olympic flame is basically a symbol of the continuity of the game from the ancient to the modern times. Okay, so that's the symbolic significance of this Olympic flame. So every year, there is a certain ceremony held in Athens only where the Olympic flame is transferred to the host city. Okay, so every time the host city, for example, in Tokyo Olympics, after the end of the Tokyo Olympics, this Olympic flame was taken back to Athens, Greece, and from here, Beijing got the ownership of this flame for the 2022 Olympics, Winter Olympics. Okay, so that is how the Olympic flame in itself is a ceremony, a story altogether related to Olympics. Apart from this, you also need to know that Paralympics also take place, and sometimes it may confuse you that what is the venue of Paralympics. So guys, it's a static fact that Paralympics, be it the Summer Paralympics or the Winter Paralympics, yes, Winter Paralympics also take place. So Summer Paralympics or Winter Paralympics, both of them succeed, or we can say are consecutively held after the main Olympics. After the Summer Olympics, the Paralympic Olympics start, as we have seen in the Tokyo Olympics case. Okay, after the end of the Tokyo Olympics 2020, the summer edition, the Summer Paralympics started. After the end of the Winter Olympics, the Winter Paralympics start. Now guys, I know that majority of you, or some of you maybe, may be thinking that why haven't we heard about the Winter Paralympics taking place anytime. The reason is that India does not even participate in the Winter Paralympics. Why is it so? I will come to that, but first let me give you a glimpse of the host cities that are going to host the upcoming Olympics, because that is important from your exam point of view. So we need to keep in touch with the exam as well before moving into the details of other things, before going into the depth of other things. Okay, so Summer Olympics 2024 Paris mein hone wala hai, 2028 is in Los Angeles, 2022 Beijing, 2026 Milano Cortina, Italy. Now guys, you should be aware of the fact that US and Australia, both of them have boycotted this Beijing Olympics altogether. Okay, so do know this fact. Then Youth Olympics 2020 was about to take place in Lausanne, Switzerland, and 2026 is going to take place in Dakar, Senegal. This is basically the 2022 edition that has been postponed till 2026. So these are the upcoming Olympic venues that you need to know. Now guys, how many medals has India won? Because this again comes back to the question with which we started the GK Factory section, that why is India not able to gain many medals in Olympics? So first, you need to know the medal tally of Olympics, of India in Olympics. So at the Summer Olympics, we have scored really well. 35 medals we have, 10 gold, 9 silver, 16 bronze. Okay, but this is very low in comparison to other countries, especially in the light of the fact that we are the second most populous country in the world after China. Even after producing so many people, having so many people, we are not able to produce good Olympians. So that's the tragedy, but we will come to know the reasons for this tragedy also. Next is India's medal tally at the Summer Paralympics. 31, 9 gold, 12 silver, 10 bronze. Now, do you know that all of these medal tallies are from the beginnings of the Olympics? From 1900s, India has achieved only 35 medals till 2020. From 1900s to 2020, only 35 medals have been won by India. Okay, and in gold, only 10. Similar is the case with Summer Paralympics. Since 1900s till 2020, the latest edition, 31 medals are in the favor of India. Out of them, 9 gold, 12 silver and 10 bronze. Highest number of medals were won in 2020 Tokyo Olympics. 19 medals were won in total. Okay. Now, In Winter Olympics, the score is really bad. That is zero. We haven't won any single Winter Olympics so far. That is why precisely, guys, Khelo India Winter Games have been organized. Okay, this is not the initial game format. It has been Khelo India Winter Games format has been recently introduced in order to boost the Winter Games in India. Okay. Next is India's medal tally at Winter Paralympics. We are not able to gain any medals at the Olympics, then Paralympics is a far-fetched dream, right? But here, there is a surprising reality. We do not even participate in the Winter Paralympics. Now, I want to discuss the reasons with you. Why aren't we able to gain medals? First of all, guys, funding is the reason, okay? People do not get enough funding. The sports people do not get enough funding to go and try their hand at Olympics. Okay, funding, then infrastructure, then societal attitude. All of these are the reasons. Okay, so these are the reasons that you must have heard somewhere or the other. But I have one or two more reasons that can be right in this scenario that why aren't we able to gain medals. First is that, because of all these situations, funding nahi hai, infrastructure nahi hai, societal pressure hai, the entire sports arena is not lucrative, all of these are the reasons. But the very specific reason why aren't we able to gain Olympic medal in my perspective is that we are not able to tap the talent at the very young age. Because if we tap the talent at the very young age, then obviously we can train that person to the highest level throughout his or her career or her journey till 20-25 years, till the time he or she becomes able to participate in the Olympics, and then we can make them Olympic ready. And precisely because of this thing, Khelo India Youth Games have been introduced to tap the young talent at the very initial stage so that we can train them according to the needs of Olympic. Okay, because it is more beneficial to train a 10-year-old boy for weightlifting, for example, in comparison to an 18-year-old person who already has developed some kind of techniques, measures, etc., etc. His body must have been accommodated according to a style of training already. But a 10-year-old kid, it would be more and more easy for the trainers also, but for the child also, it is very easy and adaptive also. So if we tap the talent at the very grassroots level, then it will be beneficial. And for that only Khelo India Youth Games have been launched. Okay, now there is one more reason that why the people are not there in the sports section, and the reason is precisely because the sector is not very lucrative. Okay, once the medal is there, once we have gotten the medal, then the entire show runs for only 1 or 2 years. After that, everyone forgets the person. Where is Abhinav Bindra right now? Do you have any news about him? What is he doing right now? Is he still playing the sport or what is he doing? If you know, then do mention it in the comment section below. So these are some of the reasons that we do not have much of the career growth ahead of it. Okay, once you have achieved the medal, then what is it? After achieving the medal at certain age, then you have an entire life ahead of you, 30-25 years ahead of you. What are you going to do in that career span? Many people like Mary Kom, they have established their own sports academies, their own sources of livelihood, as well as their sources of meaning to their lives. Okay, so through the training the girls, she has got her own meaning. But there are many sports person who haven't got any opportunity to expand further. Okay, so that is why not many people are easily able to go to the sports section, and the societal attitude is such that the parents are not easily accepting towards the sports career for their children. Now that was about the reasons. Now let me show you the gold medal winners of India. So guys, this is the hockey team, 1948 hockey team, the hockey team of the independent India that won the gold medal. He is Abhinav Bindra and he is Neeraj Chopra. Who doesn't know about him? So 10 gold medals are there. आउट ऑफ द 10 8 आर वन बाय द हॉकी टीम ओनली, हॉकी मेन्स टीम. सो दिस इज द ह्यूज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन by the hockey men's team. So you can see here that these are the 8 gold medals of Olympics that are won by the men's hockey team, and only 2 individual golds are there, which shows that we need to do more and more work towards improving the situation of the present, the status quo. So in order to improve this situation, India has already launched a TOPS scheme, that is Target Olympic Podium scheme, in order to make the people Olympic ready to get medals at Olympics. So do we need to discuss this scheme also? Of course, we are discussing about the Olympics. Why can't we discuss about the TOPS? But yes, I'm going to keep it short because I know that the session has stretched a bit long. So let's quickly discuss about this TOPS scheme. So it was launched in 2014. The purpose is to target the Olympic podium, win as many medals as we can. In 2018, the scheme was revamped to give a to establish a technical support team for managing the TOPS athletes and providing holistic support. So basically, the scheme provides the requisite support to the athletes, including foreign training, international competition, equipment and coaching camp, besides a monthly stipend of ₹50,000 for each athlete at present. Okay, so not only the training is important, not only motivation works, but livelihood is also one of the most important component that makes the people driven toward a sport or toward any career opportunity. Okay, so the Mission Olympic Cell is basically the body that assists athletes who are selected under the TOP scheme. So it is under the chairmanship of the Director General of Sports Authority, and the present person is Sandeep Pradhan. Okay, the MOC selects athletes, coaches the athletes, training institutes are also maintained by the Mission Olympic Cell. Now, in order to prepare help athletes in winning medals at Tokyo 2020, Paris 2024, Los Angeles 2028, TOPS National Center of Excellence are being set up in 14 priority disciplines. And in the month of August only, Sports Authority of India had appointed the PK Garg as the CEO of this Target Olympic Podium scheme. Guys, this is important. Do remember PK Garg, because it is very recent. Okay, his appointment is recent. So on that note, I'm going to end this session. I hope that you have enjoyed it. Goodbye, take care. And if you like this session, then do not forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the bell notification, and also like this video and share it among your friends. Thank you so much.